Tonight, an evening in the sun from Key West, Florida. It's an underwater coral reef that makes this island a diver's paradise, a fisherman's dream. But this living treasure is in great danger of being killed. It's the job made in heaven, hopping from resort to resort around the world. Tonight, we'll find out what it's really like to be a Club Med Geo. They're the Calendar Girl models who flock to this region seeking fame, fortune, and sun. See who makes the cuts for next year's calendars. All that, plus a tour of Key West's infamous Duval Street. Evening in the Sun from Key West, Florida. And now, here's Jim Watkins and Sarah Edwards.
Hi, everybody. This is one of the best ways of getting around Key West, especially the downtown area. That's where we are now. This is Duval Street,
which is
really the center of activity here on the island
of Key West.
Thanks, Maryland.
Maryland has legs like rocks. This is where the action is, Duval Street, as you mentioned, and it's great for people watching, whether it be the tourist shopping or some of the more eccentric, free-spirited locals doing their thing.
But that's one thing that's so great about Key West is you can have all this activity, but you can also have the ultimate solitude because the scuba diving and the snorkeling around Key West, some of the best in the world.
In the beautiful coral reef, but like so many of our natural resources, it too is in danger. And in our first story tonight, we take a look at efforts to save the reef.
This is the life in Key West, Florida, a booming tourism industry catering to divers and snorkelers, a fishing industry that is the envy of any Yankee. And this is what brings them here. It is an underwater life form of brilliant colors, home to hundreds of varieties of exotic fish, a living, breathing organism heralded for its great beauty. The coral reef stretches from the southern tip of Florida, 170 miles along the island chain through Key West, Florida. It is the only living coral reef in North America. And yet, it is in great danger of being destroyed.
So far, more than 11 million gallons of crude oil have spilled from the Exxon Valdez.
Oh, Valdez in the key! Oh, Valdez in the key!
This is the outcry from the people of Key West, a dreaded fear of an oil spill the likes of what happened in Valdez, Alaska, and the deadly destruction a spill could cause here in the Florida Keys.
It just brings tears to your eyes, the amount of damage that was done up there. And to attract that kind of possibility here, it would just be, I don't know. It'd be hard to tell my son in college why he's not getting any money anymore.
No Valdez in the game.
I think a Valdez type of accident's a high probability here, considering that we have, I think, a quarter of all the imported oil coming into this country transits through the Straits of Florida, right off our reef tracks.
Craig and Yvonne Quirillo are the founders of Reef Relief. They have banded together the residents of the small island community of Key West in efforts to protect the natural resource that supports both the tourism and fishing industries. Their biggest battle is against plans for offshore oil drilling that could begin as soon as October of this year.
That would devastate the reef. Even routine drilling activities would impact the health and vitality of our local waters and remove the conditions required for healthy coral growth.
On Friday, June 16th, a presidential task force assembled in Key West to hear testimony from the community on the issue of offshore drilling. The entire town shut down, with store owners draping their storefronts in black in protest to the proposed drilling.
There were so many hundreds of people that got involved in it that it became something of a legend in Key West, the Black Friday.
So when we go in, please be very careful. Do not touch the coral with your hands. Do not kick it with your flippers. And absolutely do not stand up out there. Okay, just touching the reef can kill hundreds of years of growth.
The easy access to the reef makes the Florida Keys the most popular diving and snorkeling spot in the U.S. Unfortunately, the same easy access brings with it too much traffic.
With the advent of tourism and the increase of popularity in diving and snorkeling, our reef has become, you might say, endangered from being loved to death.
They say that most reefs grow about half an inch a year. So we're looking at something that has grown over centuries. It would be a shame if in the same generation that scuba was discovered, that we also killed the reef.
One of the greatest present-day killers of the reef are the many private and commercial boats that anchor directly on the coral. Craig and Devon set up a system of mooring buoys that provided an alternative to the destructive anchors. Now there are 80 mooring buoys along the most frequented areas.
This way you can have 100 boats use a mooring buoy all day and not have the need to drop an anchor once. But I would say up to 90% of our anchor damage on the reefs we have here is eliminated, you know, through the use of mooring buoys.
While their fight against offshore drilling marches on, Craig and Devon can usually be found in the reef relief boat going from buoy to buoy, maintaining the markers and cleaning the ropes. They work countless hours on a volunteer basis in a battle to keep the reef alive.
I want to keep it alive as long as I can, and that's primarily what motivates me, is I love the reef, and that's why I live here. So to me, it's worth a couple of years of sacrifice to try and make a difference.
Thanks to Craig and Devon's efforts, we'll all be able to enjoy that beautiful coral reef for years to come. If you do visit Key West, you'll want to include scuba diving and snorkeling on your itinerary. It's only a 20-minute boat ride out to the reef. And you can even get the experience videotaped, the ultimate home video. Just ask around for Admiral Busby. He'll help you out. An eccentric character, a former country western singer turned dive master, another free spirit here on the island.
Coming up later, they flock here seeking fame, fortune, and sun. They're the calendar girl models. But next, it's the job made in heaven. Find out what it's really like to be a Club Med Geo.
I could sure use my tax refund now.
With H&R Block's Rapid Refund Program, you don't have to wait.
Great, but I'm a little short of cash right now.
With Rapid Refund, you don't need any money.
What's that?
With Rapid Refund, H&R Block files your federal return electronically with the IRS, so your refund loan is on its way to you in a matter of days. You don't need any cash. All fees can be deducted from your check, available whether Block prepares your return or not.
Now that's the way it ought to be.
That's the new Rapid Refund Program from H&R Block.
The Budget Gourmet comes in a plain cardboard box that you pop right in the microwave or oven. It costs about 40% less to manufacture than our competition's fancy packaging and saves us a bundle on production. And best of all, the money we take out of our box goes into our food. The Budget Gourmet. Expensive food at reasonable prices.
Excitement's just a phone call away.
Talk to me right now.
Midnight Caller.
Tuesday night at 10.
We've asked this couple to make a side-by-side comparison of NyQuil costing $3.99 and CVS brand cold formula costing only $2.79.
Notice any difference, folks? You're both sleeping peacefully?
That's because CVS cold formula has the same active ingredients. CVS brand. If you can't tell the difference, why pay the difference?
Save during the Washington's birthday sale. Get a $1,000 guaranteed rebate on Plymouth Laser. But hurry, see your New England Chrysler Plymouth dealers today.
40 years and still going strong. Bring the whole family to Boston's number one show, the original New England home show, World Trade Center, February 17th to the 25th. See you there.
The continuous soft hits of magic, 106.7. Relaxing music with more variety and...
Key West is like a beautiful woman.
And you thought Margaritaville was just an imaginary place. Nope, it's real, it's here in Key West, and we're relaxing in it right now.
We're just wasting away here. And on the menu, there is a cheeseburger in paradise, as heard in the Jimmy Buffett song.
This is the Jimmy Buffett restaurant and bar called Margaritaville. Jimmy Buffett, such a big part of Key West, and really it's his music that has brought the spirit of this place to the rest of the country.
Margaritaville is a bit touristy, but it is a well-known landmark here in Key West, and Jimmy Buffett does come here when he's in town. He hangs out, has lunch, and even plays for the folks.
And if he wasn't on tour right now, I have no doubt that he'd be here joining us.
Right here, sipping a margarita.
Right now, we're going to visit the ultimate adult paradise as Club Med celebrates 40 years of fun in the sun.
I was hired on the spot. The happiest day of my life. It was great.
We've got a very, very international friends now. It's very nice.
They're the symbols of eternal youth, gentil organisateurs, GOs to you and me. Their lives are a constant vacation filled with the sun and the beach and plenty of fun. If this is work, where do you sign up?
Alors, mon prénom, c'est Elios, et c'est Peter.
For the GOs, there's no change of season, just a change of village every 6 months. It's then that they get reassigned to any one of the 22 villages around the world, or the new Club Med sail ship. The GO works 18-hour days, 7 days a week, teaching, socializing, and performing. Lori, a 29-year-old Californian, felt she had a calling.
I wanted to live in a gorgeous place, be outside, enjoy the sports, use my French, meet other GOs and GMs from all around the world. It was just the perfect job for me. Vous connaissez les clubs de la zone US? C'est la première fois. We've got the hottest nightclubs, you know, in most of the places around. We've got the best food. So you don't feel like you're trapped. A lot of GMs say that. Don't you get sick that you just have to stay here? Say, would you?
Okay, but life on the beach can't be all sun and fun. What's the downside? Well, some GOs look at the job as a way to travel and see the world, when actually many of them are never able to travel outside of the village and see the country that they're in. Their $450 a month salary won't make them rich. Then again, they never have to spend any money. And some GOs aren't crazy about having a roommate.
Edit.
Remember when Club Med had the image of a free-for-all? Well, you can kiss those days goodbye. Now in its 40th year, the club is a family place. But is there still that chance for romance on your vacation?
Not all the time, but sometimes.
You meet a lot of terrific people. But it's hard to get involved for 1 week and then say goodbye. I don't really like that. I spend time with them, you know, we become friends and everything, but much beyond that is not something that I personally really go for. It's just too hard.
It's not, of course, the place to meet people, to be with a girl, not at all. If I want to have my private and own life, I will do it maybe outside.
GOs don't have to be beach bums forever. Santi, a 10-year veteran at the ripe old age of 31, has the most coveted title of chef de village, or chief of the village. His latest assignment, however, was a tough one. He actually had to reopen the Club Med village in Guadeloupe after Hurricane Hugo. But now, it's business as usual.
It's not hard to get used to the beach and the sun and all these people and the good food being fed all the time. I love to dance, so there was nothing to adjust to.
You have to be very human. To make people happy means people don't get a lot of time to have vacation, and vacation or holidays are very important for them. So if they spend 1 week or 2 weeks in Club Med, it must be the best time of their life.
So these are the lucky people who get to have the jobs of a lifetime. They're professionals. Had a good time, a great tan, and an endless summer.
Back here on Key West, the Smilin' Island, behind me is another popular hangout, Sloppy Joe's, which was Ernest Hemingway's favorite bar. Now, the original was right around the corner. This was built in 1938. But he, Ernest, would hang out with Sloppy Joe, his fishing buddy and drinking buddy, and they'd tip back a few.
Well, of course, Ernest is gone now, but his habits live on in Key West. I want to tell you people, this is a partying town. If you like to carouse a little bit, club hop, listen to live music, I guarantee you, you'll be very happy here.
It's all right here. Now, if you come in November, it's nice and quiet. You want to really party, you come in March, spring break.
Well, that's when we really want to party.
It's a happening town.
Up next, they're the Calendar Girl models who flock to this region seeking fame, fortune, and sun.
Ever play tic-tac-toe for prizes? Now you can win fabulous prizes playing telephone tic-tac-toe.
I want a big screen TV. We want a cruise.
Your touch-tone phone is the game board. Pick your category, answer simple questions, and make your move. It's fun, it's easy, and everybody can win. It's like being on a game show and winning fabulous prizes right in your own home. Call 1-900-999-9000 and play telephone tic-tac-toe. Call now and win. 95 cents a minute, no toll.
You know about violence in the inner city. You've seen the effects of crime, gangs, and drugs on these neighborhoods. But did you know that in the midst of all this, there are kids with hope? Children who can see past today and are fighting for a better tomorrow. Liz Walker introduces you to the Children in the Crossfire, tomorrow at 6 on Eyewitness News. Assignment 4, exclusively from WBZ TV4.
Introducing a daytime talk show with a sense of humor.
Everybody loves gossip. Inquiry minds do want to know, and I'm not shy about asking.
The Joan Rivers Show, weekdays at 9 on TV4. This New England Ski Report is brought to you by your local Midas dealers.
Oh, this is some nice skiing. Primary surface, packed hot or loose granular, because the snowmaker is taking advantage of these cool temperatures.
6 inches of new snow at Jay Peak, 5 at Bolton, and the Jack Williams Ski Race for Wednesday's Child this weekend at Waterville Valley. 35 trails at Pico, and great day or night skiing at Wachusett.
Well, this is fun, but if the temperatures start to warm up, look for the skiing to become even more enjoyable.
Nobody can tell you what a complete and thorough brake job will cost until they inspect your car. Nobody.
Midas gives you a full inspection up front. And for $69 per axle, we'll install organic shoes or pads. $89 for semi-metallic. Inspect hydraulics, resurface drums or rotors, repack non-sealed wheel bearings, and replace needed grease seals and fluid. So for brakes done right, remember, nobody beats Midas. Nobody.
It's always good to get back to Key West.
If you want to get away from the hustle and bustle here, you don't have to go far. I've just come a half block off Duval Street to check out some of the beautiful homes and the beautiful architecture found in the Old Town section. Being in Key West is a real treat for the eyes between the homes and the people and the ocean. And it must be a real treat for the camera, too, judging by what we've seen. In the few days we've been here, we've seen teams of models and photographers getting ready to make the advertisements and the catalogs that we'll all see in the months ahead. It would seem that when the fashion industry gets ready for the summer season, they head south for the winter.
February in the Caribbean. It's almost always the same. The weather is good, the hotels are overbooked, and the beaches are filled with stunning models.
Good. Smiley, a little friendly.
Yeah.
Good. Arch your back up and do that. Splash it like this. Good. Big smile. Good.
Calendar girls are fast becoming an island tradition. And for the past 5 years or so, scores of would-be Kathy Ireland's have descended on the Caribbean, hoping for that one shot that launches them to fame.
You never know what might happen. Who might see it and say, you know, who's that girl?
You gotta smile so bright.
When most of us meet these calendar girls, they'll be giving us their sexiest clothes for the 12 months of the year. But there is more to a picture-perfect beauty than meets the eye.
Oh my God, millions of ants.
No, really, don't shoot.
All right. Clap a towel.
Modeling is not what you think it is. It's people think that all it is a vacation, and you just sit in the sun, you get your picture taken, but a lot of hard work goes into it.
It's a tough job, and everybody's trying to do it. Come up with the year's hottest-selling calendar. Even though Sports Illustrated is the reigning queen of swimwear, Rick Diener hopes that his U.S. Virgin Island swimwear calendar will take the crown in 1991. But not even Rick was completely prepared for the battle to the top. With the sun and the beach come long hours, sunburn, not to mention mosquitoes.
Well, some of them are a little more sensitive about these things than others. Some of them are a little more likely to tough it out. Some of them get a little more upset about it.
Oh, 1 second.
Would you like some insect repellent?
Yes.
But mosquitoes and sunburn aside, posing for a calendar is fast becoming the next best thing to the cover of Vogue. All but one of last year's models were back for the 1991 edition, and the calendar even attracted a few newcomers.
I've never been to the Caribbean before, and this is an opportunity for me to travel. It was a lot of fun.
I'm a little on the lazy side when it comes to finding other work in modeling.
Okay, so some did just come for a good time, but others have been reaping the rewards of swimwear modeling.
I want to feel the camp, because I know that I'm kind of going, and I should be like,
You know what you worry about? Every part.
While Karen Crony's petite stature has left her out of work, she is a perfect fit for a swimsuit, and she's moving to Los Angeles, where she hopes she can model full time.
You know, a lot of people say, well, there's so much competition out there, but that doesn't bother me because there's so much more work, so either way I'm going to get more work anyway. So I'm excited. I'm ready to go.
Turn the face a little bit this way.
Good.
In Hollywood, a bit part is still a part by any other name. Leslie Glass nabbed a role in the Rocky V picture as a ring card girl and has been getting friendly with the boss, Sylvester Stallone.
Yeah, we're sort of friends, I guess you could say. We talked last night. He's a nice guy. We're both from Maryland, a matter of fact. So, that's good.
I don't know, it's too elegant, yeah.
But Joelle Wiggins would prefer not to be just another swimsuit model.
I don't want to be categorized as just a body. I want to do some high fashion, some face shots, and some commercial work.
The hardest part of the calendar has yet to come, sorting through all of these pictures for the 12 best poses. And there is the question of which of these bathing beauties will make the calendar cover.
There isn't a chance that I would answer that question.
You make my life so rich. You know you could have been some...